Now, the investigation, which, as we have said, is so multifaceted and is taking place in so many areas. Our investigative chief reporter, Brian Ross, has been covering this ably, has some more news.
More developments this morning, Charlie and Diane. Overseas in Hamburg, Germany, 8 apartments raided overnight, and SWAT teams expected to hit more places today. This is a location where Mohammed Atta had lived prior to coming to Florida, before he came to Venice and then to Vero Beach. Atta, the man who took training there and was on the flight that first hit the World Trade Center, Flight 11. They've made an arrest there of an airport employee in Hamburg who had a false passport, a false Egyptian passport. Meanwhile, in Montreal and Quebec, authorities there are also beginning to cooperate with FBI agents in trying to unravel the movements of the terrorist hijackers who are believed to have been stationed and located for some time in Montreal.
And in case someone is just tuning in, tell everyone again the news you had about the American Airlines uniforms that were stolen.
A report from Rome this morning of the theft of 2 pilot uniforms from 2 pilots last April at a Rome hotel. This has been known for some time among American employees. There have been warnings going out. As well, one of the cars seized at the Boston airport, they found a ramp pass, a restricted ramp pass in the car, with suggestions that the people in the cars, we had reported earlier, had been back and forth from the airport several times over the last 2 weeks, apparently casing it. One person suggested to me they probably did some dry runs trying to get their knives and material through security to see if that worked.
But as you mentioned earlier, and it bears repeating, because this this investigation and what's going on sort of comes to you piecemeal, and it's hard to keep track of all of it. But Brian pointing out that these 5 pilots who were training down in Florida had been in this country for 15 months with their families, some of them getting training in commercial-sized aviation planes. And so you would suspect, this Mohammed Atta's name, I suspect, is one we're going to hear a lot. You suspect that this fellow was probably at the controls of American Airlines Flight 11 when it smashed into the first Trade Center tower.
And his partner, who trained with him, was on United Flight 175, the second plane to hit the tower. With a possible scenario, these 2 buddies, one took the first plane, the other took the second plane. They knew where they were going, they knew which tower to hit.
And now raids being conducted in the areas from whence he came. Overall, the Attorney General is saying 50 people probably involved in this operation, and they think they've identified everyone who was actually on the plane, somewhere between 3 and 6 people per plane.
And the great concern now is those they have not identified, who they think may have been in the support group, still out there, still at large, still being sought.
All right, Brian Ross, thanks.